kingdom have in mind, O God. We worship and exalt thee, God, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. As we are about to hear your word, O Lord, come and be with us. We cover your church with the blood of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We cover this message with the blood of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We are children here, Lord, and those that are not here, we cover them all with the blood of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
If you are happy, truly, if you are happy, may we hear another bigger amen.
Yeah.
The topic of our message today is Jesus shall set you free.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Our Jesus is the only power that is liable to set his people free. Amen.
Amen.
No matter the situation that the people of God are facing, no matter the affliction that the people of God are facing, no matter what you have been passing through from the day you was being born, only God can bring an end to those afflictions. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
The impossibilities of the people of God, only God can make them to be possible. And the book of John chapter 8 verse 36 says, if the Son of God shall set you free, you are free indeed. Amen. Praise the King God.
Amen.
If you don't mind and you are having your Bible, please turn with me to the book of Isaiah. Isaiah chapter 51. I'm reading from verse 2 and 3. And it says, look unto Abraham your father and unto Sarah that bear you, for I called him alone and blessed him and increased him. Praise the King God.
Yes.
When God called Abraham, he was a single man. He was facing exactly the affliction that some of us are facing today. And with period of time, after he heard from God, and gradually God started transforming his situation, and there was an end towards his situation. And Sarah, our mother, if we can recall very well, from her youth age, she suffered from barrenness. But I want you to understand, there is an end to every situation, to that your affliction. What you have believed, that there is no way out, that it is impossible. But remember what God says, with man it might be impossible. But with the living God, all things are possible. Praise the King God.
Amen.
And Sarah continued with God. At the age of her 50, she was there still suffering her barrenness. To the age of 60, God was there watching her faith. God was there watching her reaction. What is her encouragement towards the Most High God? At the age of 70, our God did not perform. And when she gets to the age of 90, the living God who has made heaven and earth, who can bring an end towards your affliction, who can set you free from all you are passing through, and you shall be free indeed. And God came to his life. And God approached that problem and bring it to an end. Praise the King God.
Amen.
And if you don't mind, let's go to verse 3. And verse 3 says, for the Lord shall comfort you. Praise the King God.
Amen.
He will comfort all her waste places, and he will make her wilderness like Eden, and her desert like the garden of the Lord. Joy and gladness shall be found therein, thanksgiving and the voice of melody. Praise the King God.
Amen.
And our living God continue promising his people, he will surely bring an end to any situation that you are facing, and joy will come in into that life. Remember what the book of Psalms says, sorrows may endure for the night, but joy comes in the morning. Praise the King God.
Amen.
When an end of your sorrows comes, joy shall come in. And the Lord says, there shall be voice of melody in your life. Praise the King God.
Amen.
So no matter what you are passing through, I want you to depend upon the dependable God, who will never fail his people, who his word will ever come true in any situation and circumstances. Remember, as I told you earlier, blessings does not come from the land where you are. But blessings come from the Most High God, who has made you and made that land where you are. The same God who remembered Sarah in his situation and called her as a single young lady with barrenness, and the same God transformed that barrenness into fruitfulness unto this day. Praise the living God.
Amen.
The same God is able and capable to do it in our lives. Amen.
Amen.
If you don't mind, proceed with me again, please, to the book of Exodus to view the affliction of the people of God and how it later came to an end. The book of Exodus chapter 3, I'm reading from verse 7. If you are here, say amen.
Amen.
And he says, and the Lord said, I have surely seen the affliction of my people, which are in Egypt. Amen. And have heard their cry by reason of their taskmasters, for I know their souls. Praise the living God. Before you was being born, God knows you. And what we pass through on earth, God knows them all. And all your affliction, before you started your life journey, God knows it. Before you get to this land, God knows what we pass through in this land. Therefore, as a child of God, a child of God needs to depend upon the living God. A child of God needs to cast his body or her body unto the living God who will never fail. And when it comes to the people, to the time of the people of God in the land of Egypt, in the land of their slavery, and they keep on crying unto the living God, and they were all hopeless because they are not having reliable prophets that can direct them and let them know what is the plan of God. But I want you to understand today, God has provided reliable sources for you to understand that God will never abandon his people in any situation or circumstances, in any land where they are. God will never abandon them. But in those days in the land of Egypt, they were in confusion. They were crying and weeping, and sorrows dominate their life. But God sent forth a man called Moses from the land of Midianites, and the Lord said, I have seen the affliction of my people, and the end of that affliction is at hand. Praise the living God.
Amen.
When this end comes, and God sent Moses to go to the land of Egypt to go and deliver his people from that affliction, what you have been passing through, I don't know. What you are yet to pass through, I cannot tell. But one thing is certain and for sure, that the living God who has bred you, he's counting your steps, he knows all your affliction, and there is a mandate, an end towards your affliction. When the Son of God will set you free, and you shall be free indeed, and there will be songs of joy and melody
Amen.
In your situation. Praise the living God. And when Moses came to the land of Egypt, they were confused. And they asked him, which God have sent you? And he told them, the God which have made heaven and earth, the waters and all that is in them, he have sent him. Praise the living God.
Amen.
And when that God decided to come into your life, that situation that you believe that it will not be okay, the situation will be okay. Praise the living God. And when the God was warning his people, he kept cautioning I and you in the book of Jeremiah chapter 17 verse 5. He said, woe unto them that depend upon man. Praise the living God. A child of God needs to depend upon the living God who has made heaven and the earth, who has made that man that you are trying to depend upon. A man will fail you. Your biological parents will surely fail you. The wife that you get married to will surely fail you. Your husband might surely fail you. But there is one man who will never fail you in any situation or circumstances, no matter wherever you are. That man will never fail you. When the time of this end of affliction comes, he will surely come to that point and deliver his people. Remember the case of Peter. When Peter was hopeless, he was chained and dropped in a prison. And the hour comes, that living Elohim, who will never fail, he sent forth his strongest angels that visited him in that prison, and he was delivered successfully without the help of anyone. Praise the living God.
Amen.
But you need to pray. The power and source of communicating with God is prayer. Peter prayed, and the church of Christ, they prayed. Praise the living God.
Amen.
If you don't mind, let us turn again to the book of Exodus, 7 Exodus chapter 12. I'm reading from verse 40. Let us see how God ended a long time affliction. One of the longest affliction of God's people in the history of scripture. I'm reading from verse 40, and it says, now the sojourn of the children of Israel, whom they went in Egypt, was 430 years. Amen. When the people of God went into the land of Egypt, and numbers of years started growing, they were there for the first decade. They were there for the first century, for the second century, the third century, and the fourth century. And the whole of them were hopeless. And time comes. According to the word of God, there is an end towards any ill situation that you are passing through. And when the time comes, the living Elohim, he said exactly 430 years, he descended into that land with Moses. When God is sending his servants, he's not sending them alone. He sent them with the power of the Holy Ghost angels that we perform those miracles, those impossibilities of the people of God. They shall all become possible. Because the angels of the living God, they shall do that. Praise the living God. And verse 41 says, and it came to pass at the end of 430 years, even the self-same day, it came to pass that all the host of the Lord went out from the land of Egypt. 42. It is a night to be much observed unto the Lord for bringing them out from the land of Egypt. This is the night of the Lord to be observed of all the children of Israel in their generations. Praise the name God. When the end comes, no power can ever be held that end. Amen. Amen. So as a child of God, I want you to depend upon this living God who will bring an end to that ill situation. Are you suffering from sickness? That God will bring that sickness to an end. And you shall start to recover from all you have lost. Are you suffering from disappointments and failures? And when this time comes, your disappointments and failures will be transformed to appointments and success. Are you suffering from barrenness? One thing is certain. You need to walk with God by faith. You need to follow God with faith. You need to be steadfast in God. You need to be dependent upon the power of the Most High God. Praise the name God. Your financial poor situation, only God will enrich you and will be enriched indeed. Praise the name God.
Amen.
Let us move again to see the promises of our Lord Jesus Christ. For those that depend upon this living God, for those that waited upon this living God, you will never be put to shame. And when that living God will set you free, you shall be free indeed, according to the promise of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has died for my sake and for your sake. Turn again, please, with me to the book of John. John chapter 14, and read from verse 18. And he says, I will not leave you comfortless. I will come to you. Praise and lead God.
Amen.
When Christ was on earth, he made a promise to I and you. This promise is trustworthy. This promise is liable. It is not like the promise of your wife or the promise of your husband. It is not like the promise of your father or the promise of your mother. But it is a liable promise. Well assured promise that will never fail. And Christ says, I will never leave you comfortless. I will surely come to you. In that situation, Christ will surely come to you. Touch down to your brother or your sister. Tell that person, Christ will surely come to you. If Christ will surely come to the people of God, why are the people of God panicking in our generation? Why are the people of God living hopelessly as if to say there is no God? But we depend upon the living God who can do all things. Praise the name God.
Amen.
Please talk to me, talk with me again to the book of John, chapter 5. John chapter 5, I'm reading from verse 7 and 8. If you are there, say amen.
Amen.
And verse 7 says, the important man answered him, sir, I have no man where the water is troubled to put thee into the pool. But while I'm coming, another step down before me. Amen.
Amen.
We have read about a man who have been by the pool of Bethesda for 8 years. And we're convinced that your problem have not taken up to that 8 years. Praise the name God. And this man was there hopeless. I want to let you to understand that the promises of Christ is assured. Christ says in the book of John chapter 14 verse 18, I will come to you. No matter wherever you are you in the hospital? The living God will visit you at that hospital. Are you in the prison? That same living God will visit you at that prison. Are you in a hopeless situation? That same God will visit you in that hopeless situation. Everything that happens in your life is for a purpose. Praise the living God.
Amen.
And when this man was hopeless, by the pool of Bethesda, for a full 8 years, he was suffering of so many afflictions, so many agony. There was no man to help him. There was nobody by his side. But he kept calling upon the living God, who will come to him and deliver him. And his situation shall be transformed indeed. And when Christ came to him, and Christ asked him, what are you doing here? Your Christ is protecting you anywhere you are.
Amen.
Our Jesus is not dead. He's the living God who performed all things unto his people. He says, God of signs and wonders and miracles to the true believers. When you believe in him and follow him alone, let me tell you one thing. Worshipping God and other gods, your problem will never come to an end. If you believe in the living God who has made heaven and earth, if you believe in Jesus Christ who has died for the sake of I and you, rely on him and wait patiently upon him. According to the psalmist who prayed, he said, I will pray and wait patiently unto the living God who performs all things. Praise the living God.
Amen.
And when Christ located him by that pool, he was hopeless, but he never knew an end has come towards his affliction. The prayers you have started, you have prayed for a month, and there is no manifestation. You have prayed for the second month, and there is no manifestation. And you have prayed for 6 months, and there is no manifestation. Continue praying. Praise the living God.
Amen.
And when this man started his prayer, he prayed for the first year, for the second year, for the third year, up to 38 years. And at the very end, the God of miracle, he visited him. He heard that prayer from heaven, and Christ located him. This is how Christ will locate you in Jesus.
Therefore,
be confident in the God that we are worshiping. Why some of us has not gone down is this. When you believe in the power of the living God, no power can bring you down. In any situation you will pass through, you will always be a victor in that situation.
Amen.
Praise the living God.
Amen.
And verse 8 says, Jesus said unto him, rise, take up thy bed, and walk. And the scripture says, instantly, he was healed. Instantly, his affliction was forgotten and he became okay. Praise the living God.
Amen.
When the Son of God sets us free, we will be free indeed.
Amen.
No matter the power that is threatening your destiny, your life, no matter the power that has been chasing that life, that it will not be suitable. But when the living God comes and sets you free, you must surely be free indeed spiritually and peacefully as well. You must surely be free. Praise the living God.
Amen.
If you don't mind, turn with me to our Bible text for the day. The book of Mark chapter 5. I'm reading from verse 25. And it says, and a certain woman which had an issue of blood 12 years. Amen?
Amen.
How many years have this woman been suffering?
12 years.
And ask yourself a question, how many years have you suffered? And verse 26 says, and has suffered many things from many physicians, and has spent all that she had, and was nothing better, but rather grew worse. Praise the living God.
Amen.
When I'm encouraging the people of God to come to the living God, I'm not forcing you to come to that living God, but I'm encouraging you because I know, I'm sure and confident that the solution towards that problem is with our Lord Jesus Christ. And verse 25 says, she has suffered so many things from different physicians, from different occultic homes, as many of us, we are suffering many things today. Many of us, they will direct you to go to that occultic altar. You go to occultic altar and you sacrifice to the demonic kingdoms and your problem is not yet solved. And some of them will direct you. Go to that physician. You go to that physician and you provoke God by worshiping other gods, which are strange gods, which are gods that are not reliable, and your problem continues. And time will come. Let me tell you why some of us are poor. It's our fault. We cause ourselves to be poor. Some of us keep on sending money for sacrifice and rituals unto the money kingdoms. Some of us keep sending money. Go and empire from that little temple. How my future will be. And what the response will be this. They will tell you that your ancestors that have died maybe 150 years ago, they are the one hindering your success. But that is a lie. It's a common philosophy. They calculated what they believe that will scare you, that will piss you off, and they start telling you, are you not believing that the spirits of your ancestors are powerful than the power of our Lord Jesus Christ? As a Christian, and we sacrifice, and time we come, we will become poor. And some of us go to the graves to sacrifice for the dead, for sake of solution. And if we shall ask ourselves a common question and come to the reality, since we have been doing that, what have been the solution? Have you had any positive changes in your life? That situation where you have been walking from one occulting altar to another, have there been any changes? Praise the living God.
Amen.
And it happened on behalf of our sister of hemorrhage. And she has been there for 12 years, suffering and wasting her resources. All her words went away because she's searching for a solution. While the master solver of all problems is there, Jesus Christ is the master who can solve every problem and situation that is not Christian to the child of God. Praise the living God.
Amen.
And when she was exhausted, all she has have went away. And she heard of our Lord Jesus Christ. Praise the living God.
Amen.
Verse 27 says, and she heard of Jesus, came in place behind, and touched his garment. Praise the living God.
Amen.
If a woman should be encouraged enough that if I come to this master and touch his garment, and my problem will be solved, why are you not thinking the same as well? When you come to our Lord Jesus Christ, that your problem will be solved. We are not coming to Christ half and half, let me tell you. You are coming to Christ. When she was coming to Christ, she abandoned the ways of those physicians. She abandoned the ways of those occultic world and decided to fight to make sure she approached our Lord Jesus Christ. That Christ is moving spiritually. When he was living, he said he's not leaving us comfortless. He will surely be there with his people, even to the very end. Praise the living God.
Amen.
And as soon as this woman touched him, she was freed. And she was made whole according to the account of scripture. If you don't mind, let us continue with verse 29. And verse 29 says, and straightway the fountains of her blood was dried up, and she felt in her body that she was healed. She was healed of that plague. Amen.
Amen.
Instantly, any healing that comes from the power of the Holy Ghost, it must be permanent and instantly. Any healing that comes from the power of the Holy Ghost, we are not doubting that healing. When it comes from our Lord Jesus Christ, that situation must surely be transformed and changed. Praise the Lord. I want you as a child of God and as a believer who has believed the Son of God who came down on earth here with infallible proofs that he came and he performed all these miracles. And the cities where he performed all these miracles, we can still account of those cities today on earth. Why not believe and follow God properly? Why not believe and depend upon the living God who can set you free? Who can bring an end to those afflictions, no matter what you have lost? Remember what the book of Isaiah says in Isaiah 43. He said, forget the things of the past, the former things, and the Lord commanded you. Remember them not. Those former things that have gone in your life, you need to forget those things and depend upon the living God who can transform your ugly situation to a better situation. Praise the living God.
Amen.
And verse 34 says, and he said unto her, daughter, thy faith hath made thee whole. Go in peace, and the whole of thy plague. Amen?
Amen.
One thing is important, as I told you earlier. There is no way that you will receive blessings from God without faith. There is no way you will receive your healing from God without faith. There is no way you will receive deliverance from God without faith. There is no way you will walk with God without faith. You need to have faith upon that God. But unfortunately today, most of us are having faith in man. Everyone wants the governor to be his friend. You want to be the friend of a president because you believe that president can solve your problems. But president cannot solve your problems because president is having problems as well. Praise the Lord. To continue with our message, please come with me to the book of Job. Job chapter 42. I'm reading from verse 10. If you are there, say amen.
Amen.
And the Lord turned the captivity of Job when he prayed for his friends. Also, the Lord gave Job twice as much as he had before. Amen.
Amen.
As I told you earlier, what the Lord said to I and you is this. He says, forget the things of the past. In the book of Isaiah 43, in verse 13 and 19, he said, forget the things of the past. Those things of the old, he said, remember them no more. And he proceeded to say, I'm making a new thing in your life, in your very life. In that hopeless situation, in that shameful situation, and God said, I'm making a new thing in that situation. And he says, are you perceiving these wonderful things that I'm about to make? I shall even make a way in the wilderness. Your former possessions that you have lost, maybe it is the will of God for you to lose those possessions. Maybe God wants you to bring you closer to Him by losing those possessions. If I'm in Nigeria, I'm well sure that no Jupiter will make me to come and preach or to carry Bible around. But God permit me to lose everything that I was having. And I was deceived with a different thing that I believe I will make. And I came to this land. And today I'm happy. I've come to God. I've known God. The power of God has come into my life. This is the plan of God for me, not of what I planned. When I lost all that I was having, when I lost every hope, I was hopeless. I was demanding for my death. Those that lost me those days, we give account of what I'm saying. But today, I'm living a better life of peace. Praise the living God.
Amen.
The same idea you have ways. God might have bring you to this land for you to lose certain things that is not even important in your life. For you to come closer to the living God. And if it is the will of God, why are you crying? Why are you shedding tears? And in the book of Jeremiah, chapter 29, and the Lord says, I know my plan for my children. This plan is plan of peace. It's plan of success for everlasting growth. Let me tell you, allow your failures of the past to go away from your life and take in the power of the Holy Spirit to understand the blessings of the future. The blessings of the future are more important than the losses of the past. That was why the Lord says, forget the things of the past. Never think those things. Because those things are gone, and He's doing a new thing in your life. Before any transformation in the life of a child of God, Joseph was with his father when he was a teenager, and his father loved him, and he loved his father. And it wasn't his intention and plan to leave the land of his origin. But time comes, out of the plan, divine plan of the Most High God, and God decided to motivate his brothers to send him out of that land, and he was sold to the hands of the Midianite merchants. And from the Midianites, he was sold to the Egyptians. And from the Egyptians, he went into prison. But the Lord was with him there. Praise the living God.
Amen.
At the end of his story, he became a governor in a land that wasn't his land. That is the process of the transformation of God in our lives. So therefore, weep no more according to the scripture. Praise the living God.
Amen.
If you don't mind, let us continue. And he says, verse 11, then came there unto him all his brethren and all his sisters of all that had been of his acquaintance before, and did eat bread with him in his house. And they bemoaned him and comforted him over all the evil that the Lord had brought upon him. Every man also gave him a piece of money, and every one an earring of gold. Praise the living God. And the end of Job, the scripture says, all that he lost, the Lord bring them twice again to him. And all those that have forsaken Job, in the days of his mourning and lamentation and problems. And the thought of them came back to him again. Praise the living God.
Amen.
As we are passing a difficult situation, situation of affliction and sorrows and lamentations, people will desert you. Close friends will desert you. Perhaps your biological parents may desert you as well. The land where you are, they may desert you. Nobody needs you anymore. But depend upon God. Walk with the living God. At the end of Job, the whole of them came back again. That is how they will come back in your life in Jesus.
Amen.
To continue with our message, and to end our message, please turn with me to the book of Psalm, chapter 1, verse 8. Psalm 138, verse 8. If you are there, say amen. And he says, the Lord will perfect that which concerneth me. Thy mercy, O Lord, endureth forever. Forsake not the works of thy own hands. Amen.
Amen.
And the scripture says, the Lord will perfect that which concerns you.
Amen.
There is no doubt about that. Everything that concerns a child of God, the living God will surely perfect it.
Amen.
And he says, God will never forsake his handwork. You are the handwork of God.
Yes.
Because the scripture says, God made us in his image. Since you are the handwork of God, God will never forsake you.
Amen.
Are you in the waters? God will never forsake you in that water. According to his promise, this is a supernatural promise. In Isaiah 43, verse 2, he says, when you pass by the water will never overflow you. When you pass by that fire, the fire will never hurt you. It is a sure assurance from the Most High God that the people that depend upon this living God, everything that concerns you, God will surely perfect it. Praise the living God.
Amen.
My encouragement to you is this. Come to the living God fully. Come and try. Since you have been to so many places and there is no solution, why not come? When they call me, your family members may call you and say you have to donate money over solution of the family. Ask them to vote, which means when I was called to add money, I told them I'm not adding any money. And I'm not adding any support anywhere he wants to go. Don't include my name. I'm standing and living by the Most High God, who will never fail me. And up to this day, God has never failed me. I did not depend upon any man. I did not depend upon any power. There is no power that I have consulted to come and help in that situation. Because I know that which concerned me, God will surely perfect it.
Amen.
And God is perfecting it.
Amen.
And the same promise is applicable unto you that is a believer. That is the difference of a believer and unbelievers. Praise the living God.
Amen.
To conclude our message, turn with me to the book of 1 Thessalonians, chapter 5, verse 24. The book of 1 Thessalonians, chapter 5, verse 24. This is our last quotation and the conclusion of our message. And he says, faithful is he that calleth you, who also will do it. Amen?
Amen.
Our living God, the scripture called him faithful. In the book of Revelation, the scripture calls him faithful. And he says, faithful is that man. He's not a liar. He can never promise you what he cannot do. From the beginning of Genesis to the end of Revelation, if you can tell me one single man or woman that God has failed, I will stop worshiping God. God has not failed any man or any woman. From the book of Genesis to the book of this Revelation, all that God has spoken, the whole of them came to manifestation. He makes the dead to rise again. He makes the blind to see again. He makes the poor to be rich. The sick, he healed the sick, and they were healed indeed. Praise and thank God.
Amen.
So that one who has called you to come and worship him, who has called you to come and covenant with him, to become his child, that man is liable. St. Paul says, faithful is his holy name. He will never fail you. That which he has said is what he will surely do. But one thing is important. Live a clean life as a child of God. There is no way God will come into your life with sinful life. Sin is the barrier. The virus that has been destroying our relationship with God. The same virus that has been destroying our blessings is sin. Once we continue in sin, it will be very difficult for the hands of God to come into that problem. In the book of Daniel chapter 9, verse 4, when Daniel was praying over the captivity of the people of God, he said, God, please forgive our sins in the first place and deliver us from this long-time captivity. And God heard that prayer. When Zechariah was praying as well, in this book of Zechariah chapter 1 verse 12, and Zechariah said, we have sinned against you and we have been under this captivity for 70 years, but please forgive, let thy mercy come again. I want you to understand, if God did not forgive our sins, we will continue suffering. But once God forgives our sins, there will be changes. And I'm encouraging you as a child of God. I know it is difficult. But try all you can to live a clean life. Try all you can to walk with God. Our God is a spirit. And before you will walk with God, and before God will consider you, you must walk with him in spirit of righteousness. May God bless you in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.